is for kill your darlings. Let's talk about this idea. In writing class, in comics class, in all the times where I was curating a story about stuff, at some point, one of my teachers would say, kill your darlings. And I'm like, excuse me, what? And I will go, Sam, when you're editing, pop the name up of the person who originally said this. Thank you. But it was a concept of when you're writing, you can't have everything end up happily or always nice. All like write up, right? Like you get so invested into a story, into certain characters as you're creating things. And then suddenly you have to do something drastic to make the story move forward, AKA kill off a character or things of this nature. And you maybe feel like a pain in that because like you've lived through the story with them. You've made another level up with them or something, right? And so you have to kill them off and that sucks. As a writer, it sucks. For a second, you're like, oh, blah. And then you have to kind of like detach from your characters for a second to find where the story is ultimately leading, not necessarily where the character wants it to lead. And I definitely believe that part of my creativity is because I am tapping into other people's stories, other people's lives, other dimensions, things of this nature. I think that's half of what inspiration and the imagination is tapping into other things. So tapping into me suddenly putting a kill a darling on it is a little bit terrifying. It's a little bit like, oh, I'm messing with another person's story here. Ugh. Even if it is coming from my own imagination and everything. But why do I have to kill my darlings? Why do I have to destroy something that is like a good concrete connection with me? And I find it even more interesting as I've realized what kind of stories and creativity and how I'm like pursuing life in general has turned a bit. And I guess it's because I've left a bit of my pessimism in the past and definitely looked at the optimism or the ability to change our lives and have that active. Part of that is because of witchcraft. I get really irritated with stories now where people keep making the same mistakes over and over again. You know, we can't anticipate the world. We can't anticipate what challenges will be brought up to us. But if we keep creating our own challenges, I get real irritated with that when I witness that in other people. Once, twice, fine, but third times, fourth time, fifth times, like, come on, learn the lesson already. I've noticed this with shows. I drop off with a lot of different shows because I feel the characters are making the same mistakes over and over and over again. I feel irritated at groups of people in stories and in comic books, in movies, wherever else, because they are making the same mistake. I get irritated with stories that say that you can't break out of a cycle always because the cycle is there, it's eternal, no matter our struggle to do it, it won't happen. That irritates the hell out of me too. And I think part of that just comes from the fact that I don't feel I should have to kill my darlings to make a step forward. I feel like I should have to kill the bad things, kill the enemies, get after something else. Don't go after and kill the thing you care about the most. And I've noticed that because in stories that I really enjoy, in stories that really like bring vibrance to me, is the idea of watching characters or people go through trials and struggles, and maybe they are hit in the face again and again and again and again with problems, but they keep striving forward and they get inventive, they get creative, they expand out beyond that, and then they conquer. Or maybe they didn't conquer because maybe life got real fucking sucky for them, but they tried, they were creative, they did fine, they broke the wheel in their actions alone. I like the idea of challenging my darlings more. Challenge the creativity, challenge, find a creative outlet, a different way of thinking, something that isn't involving killing off the things you love so much. And I think that's what really gets me about it, is that concept, kill your darlings, is saying is kill the thing that you love to make it interesting. Why does I have to do that to make it interesting? Why can't happiness be interesting? Why can't the good thing be interesting? Why can't exploring positives be interesting? You know, if life is happy all the time, some people say it's boring, but I don't think happiness doesn't mean there's lack of challenges. Happiness doesn't mean that things always turn out okay. You don't always get 100% of what you want. That's not what happiness means. People being successful in things is the fact that, you know what, no, they approached something from a new angle and they got some of what they wanted. They learned a bit of a lesson that was really beneficial to them. They succeeded in life, and when a similar challenge presented itself, it learned, the person or the character, whoever else, learned from their path and how to apply that and have a creative mindset to go, you know, it's not the same problem, but I learned something here that can be applied here and I can change that and be better for the future. And my life can turn out positively because of that. That concept I like a lot more. Challenge your darlings, don't kill them. What's the point in killing off things you like? I don't want to surround myself with people anymore who keep making the same mistakes. over and over and over and over and over again. You know, people who think that they're caught in a perpetual cycle. And I think that comes from witchcraft. I think that comes from the fact that the idea of witchcraft is the fact that I am exerting my will, my intention out into the world, into the universe. That by doing a thing over here, it will cause an effect over here to better my life, to bring the thing that I want to me, or to banish the thing I don't want, like, away from me. That has the idea that there isn't some cycle I'm stuck in, and that these effects are going to actually bring me some sort of benefit to me in some way, shape, or form. Otherwise, why would I keep doing it, right? Like, why would I keep attaching and trying to better my life if at some point it's never going to get better? Like, it doesn't matter what I do, I'm on a fate cycle, I'm on a strict thing, like, it's gonna get bad no matter what. And the idea that I have to do something absolutely horrible, kill the thing I love the most, kill my darling, to make a great change in life, to make my story interesting, to find what great thing in the world that I need to do, I don't think is always true. I don't think that's a hard and fast rule for stories or for life. Anyway, have you guys ever heard of this concept within creativity and in writing specifically of kill your darlings? How do you feel about it? Do you feel that great sacrifices always have to be made? Or do you feel it's just maybe a little bit of creative thinking is really what will help out everything else? Anyway, since she is meowing right now. More it. Say hi, kitty. Do, 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 do. Anyway, I will go love on this some bit, and I will see you guys next time, which would be tomorrow, since this is part of Utober.